Hi guys, this is Chris with Living Fly Legacy. I just wanted to take a moment and give you a brief tutorial on the Crosshatch streamer. That's what I called it. I have no idea if somebody's already tied one like this. I'm sure there is somebody tying one like this, calling it something different. Anyway, it's a pretty simple pattern. I really like it. This is just a super jig. It's a mustad hook, and it's a Wopsy product. They actually put out this hook. I can't remember the size of this one in particular off the top of my head. I think it's 16th ounce. Could be, I think it's a 16th ounce. I don't think it's an eighth. Maybe it's an eighth. Who knows? It's one of those two. You basically just choose the jig hook that you want. This one here, you just start out with laying down a thread base, and then you take a medium wire. In this case it was done, and then you take whatever colors of marabou you're going to use. Now this is a darker color because it's going to be the back color. If you think about the orientation, the way this jig is going to ride, this olive is going to be closer to the top. So I start with the olive, I tie it in at the back after I've tied in that wire, and the wire has two different strands coming off of it. Then I tie in the belly color, which is usually a lighter color. In this case, it's cream because I'm doing an olive. I love that combination of cream and olive. I think cream, I don't know, is a really good trigger color for fish. Once you get those two tied in at the back, what you're going to do is you're going to pull your marabou out of the way, and you're going to lay down a dubbing base. And you can be pretty generous with the dubbing that you want to use. In this case, I just use kind of a dark olive because this, again, is going to be the back of the fly, the very farthest back on the fly. Now, you could use something even darker. You could use a dark gray or darker brown, whatever you want, whatever you think models the back of a minnow better for whatever particular minnow you're trying to model it after. This is kind of a sculpin color. Anyway, you can dub on a pretty generous amount. What you're going to end up doing later is you're going to be brushing this out, and it's going to give a little bit more smooth nature to the fly. So I'm fairly generous with the dubbing here. I don't think there's any need to go create a dubbing loop. If you wanted to do a dubbing loop, it may allow you to be more generous with the dubbing. However, I save time. I don't think it's really necessary, but you can if you want, if you're into that sort of thing. Once you get that dubbing base laid out there, then you're going to first bring forward your back color, in this case my olive, and you'll tie it down. I think I have a malfunction here in a second. It's going to break the thread. In fact, this was actually the second time I broke the thread, and it was a little frustrating. But, you know, that happens. So, anyway, I'll get that tied back in. Once you lay down that back color, get that tied down, then what you're going to do is you're going to actually bring forward your belly color, in this case my cream, and bring that toward the front, tie it in, snip off the excess. Once you've done that, you're ready to actually do the crosshatch portion of this fly. This is the reason I named it this. What you'll do is you'll run underneath the fly, come underneath, and then you'll wrap in a angular pattern toward the front. Then you'll tie that wire down and you will spin it off or clip it off, however you want to do it. Then what to do is you grab the other wire and you'll go the opposite direction. You'll still go underneath the hook first and then over the top, and I will actually cross both on the top and on the bottom of the fly, and it'll give it this kind of cross-hatched pattern. This adds a little bit of strength to the fly, and can also give it a little bit of a barred look, a subtle barred look. So, I mean, choose your color according to what kind of barring you want it. If you just want it to look like scales, you know, match whatever pattern it is you're doing. If you want it to look more like lines, you can go darker. Then I finish off with a hot spot. This is just some bright blend dubbing, some red bright blend. And I really like the red. I think when you're tying a pattern like this, that type of hot spot can really trigger the bite because the fish think it's wounded. Now the fun part, once you've done all that, it's a pretty simple tie. All you gotta do is you gotta brush it out. You're just going to brush out the back dubbing generously, make it give it a little more body to the fly. Also, it brushes out that hot spot, makes it look like, it's bleeding, or maybe the gills are torn or something like that. And don't be afraid to brush out the marabou, too, that you've run that crosshatch over. It'll give it a little bit more fuzzy, buzzy action there. And then you're good to go. That's it. Super simple pattern. Really effective. I like the fact that it rides really narrow in the water. Tice them up. Fish them. They're great.